I know you do a lot of business with us.
A little bit.
I don't do too much in the retail store, but I know you know Greg and Craig Michael, those guys down there, so.
Yeah.
You come highly recommended from Pat Martin.
It's been a while since I've seen Pat.
Okay.
He does amazing work.
Yeah.
He's an amazing welder.
Yeah, he did. We were out there last Friday. He built that bracket for the trans brake switch and mounted this seat. Just mix some shit.
He's fast. He's got mad fast skills.
My dad, Weaver.
Hello.
How are you doing?
How are you today, sir?
Good.
So, we just bought this car a month ago.
Okay.
We picked it up and went straight to the racetrack because the guy allowed us to run it to see what it would run before we bought it.
Right.
Its major issue was when it would set down from the wheelie, the front tires would shake.
Okay.
So, just want to see what you think about the alignment. We fixed some other stuff since then, but just totally default to what you think as far as the settings go.
Yeah, let me get it racked up and look it over and see what bits we need to get for it.
Great.
You go from there?
Okay.
Cool.
Thank you.
How much you weigh?
I weigh 205, 210.
It's got something weird going on with bump steer.
Seems like a lot of slop in the gearbox.
So it's towed out, the cambers are a half degree off, the caster's 3/10 of a degree off. Caster probably won't be able to be adjusted on this. That is an interesting bump steer. That's gonna probably go away. They've got something welded into the knuckle.
Right.
And what I normally do is adjustable setups. So these go into your where your rod end is, and then you can use shims to adjust the tie rod end up and down until you get it right. Like right now, it's towed out negative 0.35, and then on lift, toes in. It's already towed in a half, almost a full degree towed in. Now it's towed in 2 degrees in the initial setting. 2.5 degrees, and you're already out of travel. So at least it's towing in on lift, but it's towing in substantial. So to fix that, I would put a bump steer kit on it and dial that in so that no matter where you are through the range, you're gonna hit as close to zero tow as possible, because then you have no deflection, which keeps your car going the fastest in a straight line.
So what does that look like? Put the bump steer kit in.
Well, those are welded on, so they're going to need to be cut off. That's just a tube, a really long bolt, so it's not that big of a deal. I would also go set a long travel long travel struts with coils or different coils.
We have new struts and new springs coming. We can't use a coil over. Super stock won't allow us.
Oh, okay.
So we have to keep the spring and the strut configuration has to remain in the stock location.
Okay, that's fine, but you can do a long travel strut.
Yeah, we have
with a better spring, yeah. Like a what do they call them, trick springs or whatever.
Yeah, absolutely. Those are on the way
because these look to be cut coils,
right? So when that happens, we bring it back to you and we reset it. Then when we change the struts and springs, that's my question. Okay. Okay, so let's think about this for a minute, Rich. So we got new Santup struts and springs coming.
Right.
So is it logical to do the bump steer kit and all that once we have that installed? Or do we do the bump steer kit now? We're talking 3 or 4 months before we have those struts, and I want to race it between now and then.
I would do the bump steer kit now.
Okay.
And then worry about the struts later, because then you can enjoy the vehicle and see the car.
Is that something you have time to do today?
Yeah, I can do it.
Okay.
They really welded that on there, and then they put a,
put a gusset on it. But the thing is, like the forces of tow are minimal, especially if you have it set up right, because your tire is literally just lifting up and coming back down. It doesn't have the side loads.
Right.
Where this one right now, when you come down, your tires are like a V snowplow.
That's no good.
So not only is it going to hunt for one tire to go straight, I mean, and if you know. and your body torques on lift, right? So when you let down, one tire's gonna hit first, and that's the, yeah. that's gonna cause your weirdness. Is 3 degrees a lot? Not really, but when you're doing the stuff you guys are doing in these cars, it is a substantial change.
Okay.
I'm not seeing anything else sticking out at me. The new Saginaw bit box is kind of, I would say, necessity. Changing that won't change what I do. It might make the steering wheel off a little bit from where I had it, but it's not going to change anything in the front chassis.
I don't know how long it's going to take. Maybe between 3 and 5 hours to get it done, plus the materials.
Okay.
You guys want to hang out in the RV while I do it?
Yeah, we can leave and come back, Rich. Okay. So give us a ballpark where we're at money-wise.
Be under $1,000. $600.
Cut it and grind it.
So the third gen kit, the difference, the only difference between the third gen kit and the G-body kit is the adjustment sleeve's a half inch longer on the G-body kit versus the third gen kit. Third gen kit's not available, G-body kit is available.
Use the G-body kit.
Same threads, same everything.
And it's a full shank? Or is it tapered?
It's a tapered. That's so you have to put a bolt.
I can't do, yeah, I did. I just have to do grade A bolts.
This thing has pretty massive bolts in it, so I can probably just reuse his bolts.
Let me ask you this, is there anything we can do?
Yep.
If we just adjust it and do it all at once when we get the struts and the springs, what do you think about that plan? You just give me your best adjustment with what you're working with here?
There's nothing to adjust there. I mean, I can set the toe differently and match up your caster and camber, but I'm going to be doing it all again after you've had it all apart.
Right.
So, because these bump steer links are welded in and not adjustable, there's nothing I can do to improve your bump steer. I mean, I can cut a quarter of an inch off of it, but without doing it, it's not going to be accurate.
Why don't you just do that, Rich? Why don't you just give us your best alignment with what we got here, and then we'll do it all at once when we get the struts and the springs.
Okay. New steering box and all that.
I'll lop a little bit of it off so I can improve the bump steer, and if it doesn't, I can push in it.
Let's do that.
All right.
Let's get that.
I'm good with that.
Okay.
Yeah, we'll give you a call here in a little bit. And
okay, we're going to run down and buy some gas in the motorhome and stuff.
Okay.
Get something to eat.
Yeah, go run some errands, have some lunch.
Okay, sounds good.
I'll play with your Firebird.
All right, sounds good. Thank you.
This is full on. There's the right way, the wrong way.
The way that gets it done until you do it the right way. Let's play with the strut towers. This thing has a ton of positive camber in it. Strange. Why so much positive camber? So the customer says when he comes down, when he lets off the gas at the back end, it comes down, the steering wheel goes crazy, and front tires go all over the place. So we've got a ton of positive toe, so as soon as it comes down, it's going to hunt for the tire that's going to direct it. Positive camber, so they're out, and when they droop, they're going to droop probably more positive. Yeah, so we got 4 degrees positive camber on this side, 3.3 degrees positive camber on that side. So let's take our camber negative first. Let's make sure our upper strut mounts are locked down correctly. I'm going to recommend he gets better upper tower mounts, and then play with it from there. Strut towers have been drilled for camber caster adjustments, so I can move front and back, so I can solve our caster, because it's a full degree off side to side as well. My rear thrust angle is great at 0.02. I'm not going to worry about that. Start the caster.
15s. Going in's gonna give me more negative camber, going back's gonna give me more caster. Those adjustments, my camber's dead on at a -1 degree. And when it lifts, those are going to go positive. Before they were already positive, and they go more positive. So now we've got negative camber, and then it'll sweep through the range of motion probably to about 1 degree positive on lift, but I'm okay with that. Now I need to balance out my caster. My caster on this side is almost a degree less than that side. That side I obtained 4.5 degrees. I'm going to grind the strut tower and try and make this side match it, because I'm doing what I can with what I've got. I'm going to make it as good as I can with the bits that are on the car for now, because they are going to a long travel strut, a different front coil, and we're going to lop off the homemade bump steer thingy and put a proper bump steer on it that's actually adjustable. But I'm going to take some of what's on here out so that I can obtain better toe in on turn on lift. All right, let's get grinding. And the rod ends are pretty close. No, they're really not too close. Rod ends are 1/4 inch different length. Let's see which way I need to take them to balance them out. That one's longer. This one needs to be shorter. Alright, so I set my toe and re-swept my caster. My caster changed quite a bit. I'm actually at 4.8 caster on the passer side, 1 degree negative camber on the passer side. I was at like 3.3, I think, when I started, so I gained a degree and a half of caster on the passer side. Now my caster on the driver's side is only at 4.4, but I have more room to adjust on this side, so I'm going to add a little more caster. And my camber ended up at -1.2, so I'm actually going to balance that back to 1 degree negative caster, and then I'll reset the toe. Then I'll start over with a resweep, make sure everything's consistent, and then we'll play with bump steer a little bit, because bump steer is just going to be me grinding down the welded on extensions to get my angle right to where I want it to be. So no big deal. And if I take off too much, I can throw a shim in there and build it right back up. So not a big deal. This way, these guys can run this thing for the next few months while they're waiting for some parts to come in. So yeah, let me do that real quick. All back apart, so I'm not going to split hairs over a tenth of a degree. Let's re-sweep our caster. Picked up with the sink we did. I'll make it worse. I don't think I made it worse. Always better. Just takes work.
How's it going?
Doing pretty good, man.
Days and
they bind when they're in full extension.
Well, folks, we're going to end that one there. Long day, long experience. That one is a prime example of why it's very hard to give a good quote on how long it takes to do a job like that. Because you really never know what you're going to get into until you see the vehicle, especially if it's something where somebody is purchasing it and they weren't part of the build. There's a lot of little experiences and little tricks and little hang-ups that are going to be hiding from you that you're not going to realize until you're on the rack. The trick with the bump steer kit with being welded in there, that one just had a lot of little surprises. Unfortunately, those little surprises add up and they take a lot of time. And this is a for-profit business, so that kind of thing unfortunately means it's more money, more money, more money, more money. Now that vehicle is going to be getting all brand new everything in the front of it. At this point in time, it's a heck of a lot better than it was. Your caster and camber are balanced out. The bump steer is pretty dang close, at least as close as we could get at this point in time. Should be a lot better driver, a lot more stable than it was when it showed up. And it'll at least get those guys the ability to go out and have some fun for a couple of months while they're waiting on their long travels, their new shocks, their new springs, their new bump steer kit, all the other stuff that you could put on the front of that car. They just don't have it at this point in time. And this at least gets them to the point where they can enjoy it for a couple of months, get all those new parts back on, and then get it back in here to do it all over again. But when we have properly adjustable stuff, it's a lot easier process. So, but that's what it is. I do apologize for all the background noise in this one. You're going to be hearing a lot of air compressor noise. We were hammering away on our vapor hone machine over there in the corner, which stresses out that air system quite a lot. We'll work on the AC compressor or the air compressor situation once we've paid for that dyno, maybe. Anyway, thanks for being here, guys. We appreciate it. As always, merch stuff, lucorauto.myshopify.com. If you're interested in merch, we've got a couple of different shirts up there, hoodies that are up there, stickers coming soon. Those may be up by the time you see this video. Anyway, there you go. That's what it is. We'll see you on the next one, guys. Take care. Bye-bye.